So should I pursue a degree in mathematics or software engineering? Although I want to become a software engineer at the end of the day, because you'll be better at algorithms and all these other things that will help your software engineering. Well, here's the thing. Software engineering and mathematics are both highly challenging, but yet rewarding fields. However, there's some key differences you need to be very careful and pay attention to before you pick which route you want to go to. The first thing you always want to pay attention to is salary and job availability. So software engineers generally make more than mathematicians, and there's a way better job outlook compared to mathematicians. So
according to the Bureau of Labor Statistics, employment in software engineering is projected to go 25% from 2022 to 2032, with 1.7 million jobs in 2022. Meanwhile, mathematicians had the job outlook of only 30% with only 35,000 jobs in 2022.
If you want a certain title attached to you, recognize what numbers and paychecks are going to be following your title and your degree. So now, if we take a look at job titles and hiring, software engineers usually hold the titles of software engineer, while mathematicians typically use names such as data scientist, analyst, researchers. And because of this, when you have those titles, let's say from your previous jobs on your resume, it makes it harder for companies to hire you as a software engineer. Although maybe you have done your due diligence in learning it, it's harder to initially get into the field, because when a recruiter sees your resume, they know a mathematician doesn't go through tons of coding in college. Companies who prioritize those with a STEM background that's related to computer science, electrical engineering, or even mechanical engineering, because they technically do more coding in their career process in college than a mathematician. The next key factor that you gotta pay attention to is that software skill set that's given to other engineering majors that aren't given to mathematicians. Just because you're really good at mathematics, shapes, or geometry, it doesn't mean you're gonna be excellent when it comes to using all of these softwares. When it comes to MATLAB, using Python, while mathematicians excel at solving problems, algorithms, and mathematical concepts, software development requires a broader skill set. So if you're finding value in this video, be sure to hit the like button, subscribe button, and let me know your thoughts. Is it better to get a mathematics degree or a software degree first in the comment section down below? So the next thing we're gonna look at, how software compares with all the mathematics you learn in college. Anybody who's working in the field, you'll learn quickly that a lot of the things that you do in the software does not require all the math that we learn in college. Software development usually involves not as much as former math that mathematicians may be thinking of. So you have to build a lot of skills that's outside of mathematics itself. And the number one thing a mathematician needs to have is the ability to adapt. Any engineer needs to have that skill. And if you're a mathematician and you're trying to do software engineering, I highly recommend you be fluid and being able to adapt and learn, because anywhere you go, you're gonna be learning new software updates, and you're gonna have to be on top of it. Although that has nothing to do with math, you better have a desire to be fluid and adapt quickly. So we're going to look at what makes a good code, right? From a coder's perspective to somebody who's a mathematician who's trying to go into software engineering, these are the number one requirements that will make you make whatever you write a good code. So number one, you have to be organized. A clear and well-structured code is easier to understand and maintain. The second thing you need is logical thinking in your code. Software design often involves logical reasoning and problem-solving skills. You also need continuous learning. Programming is a very dynamic field, and staying up to date to all the new technologies and practices is very, very crucial. There's new languages, and then there's new add-ons where you can connect to other languages, and you gotta be on top of it. And last but not least, designing and maintainability, right? You have to prioritize code that is easy to understand, modify, and debug. All of these things make a good code. You didn't necessarily need to be excellent at math to make a code that somebody else can read, somebody else can understand, your manager can't understand. But that's just good code. Now, how do you become a great programmer, a software engineer? Although you have your mathematician degree, how do you become a great programmer, right? To excel in programming, this is what you need, right? First, you need to be interested in design. You gotta understand the principles and patterns of software design, right? Two, you need to be open to learn from others. Seek guidance from experienced programmers and collaborate on projects. And three, you have to get a lot of hands-on experience. There's a lot of boot camps you can go to, the Udemy, GitHub, but you're not gonna learn or be as efficient until you select a project that you wanna do by yourself with no help. So don't just read about the design, actively engage in coding projects to gain practical experience. If you don't have a job yet, maybe find a friend who's working on a project and see if you can be a part of it, just so you can start getting your toes dirty, getting your fingers wet into the process. So the choice between mathematics and software all ultimately comes down to what you truly want to do. I'm just showing you in my perspective. Your perspective may be different. Maybe you don't care about the job outlook. Maybe you don't care how much they make. Maybe you just want to code and that will make you happy. Both fields have promising paths, right? If you're worried about money, if you're trying to reach to the top, any company will pay their top mathematicians a lot of money so that they can solve the problems that regular people can't solve. At the same time, many companies will pay their top software engineers a lot of money for solving problems that regular people cannot solve. So either side of it is well, but if you're a mathematician, you're trying to be a software engineer, I would highly recommend you just jump into the field itself and add mathematic courses that you enjoy onto your way to graduation. So by the time you graduate, you're already ready to be a software engineer. Companies will put you in for interviews. And at the same time, you're gonna have that background of mathematics to always be able to transfer that to a mathematics position if you needed to be. Thank you. I'll see you guys in the next video. Jodabeni.